It's all about the people. Alan signs people. He believes in the people.
Outsiders, chancers, lunatics,
misfits, drug addicts and sociopaths.
I think it was like the ultimate fucked up family.
I think probably any band that's worth its salt is a dysfunctional family, hell to be in, but makes good records, as long as they can stay together. And that's probably true of a label.
It was all about the music and the clothes and the drugs and fucking football and going out and having a great night out, you know what I mean? Who wouldn't want to be in the middle of all that?
Alan had a vision, and we all shared that vision.
I was absolutely delusional. I actually thought I was up there with Beethoven or Shakespeare, that I was creating metaphysical history by running Creation Records.
None of them had been involved in record companies before. They were making it up as they went along.
It was just the best label.
Probably one of the top 10 labels in the last 50 years.
They never really thought about the money.
They'd release records that other labels wouldn't.
I was a huge fan of Teenage Fan Club and Primal Scream and My Bloody Valentine. So when it became apparent that Creation were interested in signing us, we jumped at the chance.
The great thing about Creation was, you know, they didn't give a fuck. They were risk takers and they loved rock and roll.
Oasis, arguably one of the most important bands of the last 20 years, but everywhere in the world.
It's not often that small labels come that big, you know.
At the very beginning, it was just a bunch of fuck-ups. Didn't know what they were doing, but the job got done.
It was a great label to be on because it gave us the freedom to do what we wanted. They financed our fucking dreams. And even when they never had any money, they went out of their way to find the money to do it. It all paid off, really, in the end.
It was hugely carried along by enthusiasm in the beginning, and then at the end, it was people doing it because it was a job.
The business side of it was looked after by someone else.
You go in for a meeting on Friday night and Monday you leave and you're like, what happened there? It's like one hell of a weekend, you know.
The books I'd read about rock and roll had prepared me for this. This is what it was supposed to be like.
Being able to behave as badly as you possibly could and being applauded for it was kind of good fun.
There are rock and roll moments. We can talk about drugs, can't we?
I'm not at all proud of how I behaved.
I was more often that I was out of my mind than I was ever sober. It didn't seem to affect the artistic decisions that I made.
We rewrote pop history with lightning.
It was all fucking brilliant. We'd all like to relive it again, but we can't.
Creation Records story is just about the death, the end of the independent thing.
I think if you asked any single band now, we'd all love to be back on Creation.
Just what is it that you want to do?
We want to get loaded, and we want to have a good time.